Hi, boys and girls. My name is Matt Yu, and I'm here to explain what a time frame is.
Hi, boys and girls. Welcome to Dot Dot Toys. Today, we are going to be learning about a tense frame, which is this right here. I was actually going to explain it, but when my friend found out about it, he asked me if he could do it. So take it away, Math U.
Hi, boys and girls. My name is Math U, and I'm here to explain what a tense frame is. What you see now is a tense frame. It is empty right now. We call it a tense frame because it has 10 empty blocks in it. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 5 blocks on the top and 5 blocks on the bottom. The 10 frame lets us see really fast how many blocks are filled and how many are empty. My friend is going to show you how you can use a tense frame with counters. Take it away!
Thank you so much, Math U. To start, I'm going to use these little muffins as my counters. Now, when you're using a tense frame, you use counters. So I'm going to place one counter in each square. So right now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now, as you know already, there's 5 on top, and there's also another 5 on the bottom. So if I have 5 on top, and I take away 1, without counting, how many are left? Right, 4. I didn't have to count because I knew there's supposed to be 5, but I took one away, so now there's only 4. But if I put it back, I know right away there's 5. And I didn't have to count because in my tense frame, I know there's always 5 on top. So now I have my 5 on top, and I'm going to continue adding. So now I have 5. What comes after 5? Right, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Right now, I have 10 counters. And I know that because the whole tense frame is covered. Let's just say now I take one counter away. You should know that there's how many counters now? That's right, 9. And I didn't have to count because I knew there's 5 here, 6, 7, 8, 9, and I know there's 1 missing, so 10 take away 1 is 9. Now let's say that I took all my bottom counters away. So let's say all my bottom counters away. Without counting, how many are left? That's right, 5. How did I know that so fast? Because I know that there's 5 on top. Math U and I really want us to practice our tense frame. So let's have some fun.
I'm back. Did you miss me? Okay, so let's use my tense frame to solve some addition problems. How many counters do I have here? Try not to count. That's right, 5. How did I know that so fast? Right, because I know there are 5 blocks on top. So now let's place 2 yellow counters. Now instead of starting from the beginning and counting all the blue and yellow counters, I know there are 5 blue counters already. Now I can just count on. What comes after 5? Right, 6 and 7. So 5 blue counters plus 2 yellow counters equals 7. 5 plus 2 equals 7. Okay, how many counters do I have here? Right, 4. How do we know that so fast? Because I know there's 5 blocks on top, but in this problem, 1's missing. So 5 minus 1 is 4. Now I'm going to add one more yellow counter. How many do I have now? Try not to count. That's right, 5. So that means 4 plus 1 equals 5. So how many counters do I have here? My top blocks are all covered and there's one on the bottom. That's right, I have 6 blue counters. Now I'm going to add 4 yellow counters. How many do I have now? So this is an easy one. How many are there? That's right, if my tens frame is all covered, that means I have 10 counters, which tells me that 6 plus 4 equals 10. How many blue counters do I have here? My whole tens frame is almost covered except one block. So that means I have... That's right, I have 9 counters. Now I'm gonna add 1 yellow counter. How many do I have now? That's right, 10. How did I know that so fast? Because my whole tens frame is covered. And I know in my tens frame I have 10 whole blocks. So 9 plus 1 equals, you got it, 10. Great job. Now in this problem, I have 5 blue counters on top. I knew that really fast because I know there's 5 blocks on top. Now I'm going to add 5 yellow counters on the bottom. Wow, my whole tens frame is covered. So that means that 5 plus another 5 equals, that's right, 10. Awesome job. Okay, here comes another addition problem. In this one, I'm going to start with how many blue counters? That's right, 8, because I have 5 on top all covered, and I have 3 on the bottom that are covered. So I started with 8 blue counters. Now I'm going to add how many yellow counters? That's right, 2. So that means 8 plus 2 equals, good job, 10. You knew that, why? That's right, because my whole tens frame is covered. Awesome job. Okay, here comes another problem. How many blue counters do I have? I have 5 on top, and then I have 2 on the bottom. That's right, that's 7 blue counters. Awesome job. Now I'm going to add 3 yellow counters. That means I have 7 plus 3. What's 7 plus 3? Check out my tens frame. Is it all covered? That's right, it is. So 7 plus 3 equals, that's right, 10. Okay, let's do one more problem. Look at this tens frame. Do you see anything on it? That's right, nothing. It's empty. So how many counters do I have? 0. Now I'm going to add some yellow counters. Let's see how many I add. How many did I add? That's right, 10. So 0 plus 10 equals, that's right, 10. Awesome job, boys and girls.
Well, I hope you learned a lot about how a 10 frame works. If you did, please give us a big thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe. All right, that's it for now. Bye.